Hi Airofit family, Sean Coakley here again, Airofit Master Instructor. Here today to talk a little bit about the importance of the initial test that you take when you utilize the Airofit device. So, why do we measure the vital lung capacity to begin with? Well, as part of the compliance mechanisms in the modules or sessions that you do, in order for the app to help you make progression, we want to understand what your capacity is when you start using the device. So when you take your vital lung capacity, you're going to be measuring your inspiratory strength, your expiratory strength, along with your total capacity or the amount of air that you can move in and out of your lungs at your maximum capacity. When the device projects those numbers and allows the app to calculate what your foundational capacities are, it then knows how to grade you properly when you do each session. So let's get in a little bit about how to actually do the test so you can do it consistently the same way every day so you don't make dirty data, as I call it. We want the technique to be similar every time you do it, and we want the setting almost to be the same every time you do it, within reason. So first and foremost, as I've said in previous videos, you should have an empty stomach when you're doing this test. You don't want anything restricting the movement of your diaphragm. When you prepare to take this, I want you to be as relaxed as you possibly can. I want you to think about the positioning of your body. So from today forward, if you do the test in a seated position, always do the test in a seated position. Try to, even if you can, sit in the same way, if you will, the same postural position, so you get the same reaction from the muscles in your body when you're doing this work. As you put the device in your mouth, I don't want you to get overwhelmed or overwork or think that you have to attack this. I don't want you to go crazy when you do this. I want you to relax. The device is going to prompt you when you first put it in your mouth to exhale to relieve all of the breath out of your body. And then you're going to have to take a strong, continuous inhale so you fill up your body with air as much as you possibly can in preparation to blow the air out at force as well. The measurement of the lung capacity is taken on the exhale. It is not taken on the inhale. So when you're inhaling against a power meter, if you will, and you're looking to measure the strength of your inhale capabilities. When you exhale, you're actually measuring two things. You're measuring the strength of your exhale, as well as the amount of air that you can breathe across the sensor. As you're holding the app, you'll notice as you breathe out, it's going to count the liters of air that's coming out across the sensors in the device. And that's what's going to be the calculation for your vital lung capacity. So again, it's very important that you do this consistently. The sensors in this device are very sensitive. You'll notice that if you do a couple different vital lung capacity tests, the outcome might not be exactly the same every time. It might be 0.1 or 0.2 difference. Those differences are important to someone like me because we want to have consistency and understand over time how you make progress. Over time, as you use the device, you should always go back a couple times a week at least and do your vital lung capacity test so the app understands the progression that you're making and can recalculate the compliance measurements that it calculates for you. Again, if you do a vital lung capacity test and you do it easy and get a really low score, you'll probably get 100% compliance on every session that you do. The goal here at Airofit is to help you make progress and help you become a better breather. So when you do the VLC test, do it to the best of your ability. Push all the breath out of your lungs when you're getting that measurement of liters. So when you finally go into the sessions, you're going to be graded in a way that makes you work to increase your performance over time. So again, let's step back for a second and say the basics one more time before we leave. A nice relaxed postural position, an empty stomach, consistently holding the device in your mouth the same way every time if you can, and getting a routine or a habit of how you approach the test so you can get the best results and make them consistent over time so you can track and validate your progress, because that's what we want to do here with you at Airofit. So again, enjoy the process, have a little fun with it, smile before you do it, and relax and understand that what you're doing is making your life better in every way possible. So let's go out and train together and stay a breath ahead.